Hey, what's up, art lovers? It's SP. Welcome to my amazing art channel. In this channel, I upload how to draw portrait drawings. So if you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button and don't forget to press that bell icon. It's free, man. So in today's video, I'm going to draw Robert Downey Jr. Or you can beloveddly known him as Iron Man. Love in 3000, man. He is an American actor and a producer. His career has been characterized by critical and popular success in his youth, followed by period of success, abuse and legal troubles, before a resurgence of commercial success in middle age. He is popularly known for many acting skills, but the main acting, or I can say that main thing that make him from down to up, is his actor role in as an Tony Stark in Iron Man. He is also our beloved Sherlock Holmes. So let's dive into this drawing. Few days back in my Instagram feed, I found this picture, or I can say that reference picture, on a post that was a little bit of less in likes, or I can say that engagement thing. But the main focus or a good thing about this sketch or reference picture is that it just uses darker pencils, or I can say that charcoal or a darker things for just detailing outlinings of this picture. And outlining it, just doing outlining, it is looking a perfect sketch. Not any shadowing, not any other darker things, or as I always say that light portions or any other stuff. Just doing outlining with darker pencils, it is looking a perfect sketch. Most of the artists that you can see on road or any other things that who can make a sketch in just 10 to 15 minutes use the same technique for outlining or darker portions. They don't go for shading of many things, or they can say that they just uses the main focus of a picture or a portrait. The main focus of this portrait is his beard, his eyes and his hair thing. As you can focus from a reference picture, beard, or you can say that a symbolic thing about Tony Stark or Iron Man is his beard and his mouth mustache, or I can say that his hairs too. So just using outlining them, it is looking a perfect sketch. I always do shading, highlighting and any other things, but my main focus about this drawing is that you can go for a perfect sketch, or I can say that portrait sketch, just by doing outlinings. So in this sketch, I have seen, or I can say that for every time, I have just used grid methods. If you don't know about grid methods or want to know how to do a grid method for a perfect sketch, just comment down below. I'll make another sketch for that. I am just using a charcoal pencils. Just focus that I am just using charcoal pencils for a whole sketch. I have not used any graphite pencils or any other things. But the main focus of this picture will be going for a detailed, or I can say that every other thing that I can see from this reference picture or outlining thing. Main focus will be his beard and his mustache and his hairs, not any other things. We use layer things, we use many other highlighting things, we use many portions, or I can say techniques for hairs, for any other things in hairs, or used a rubber or a particular rubber for shadowing and many other procedures for hair things. But the main focus, or I can say main part of this sketch, will be darkening the sketch, or I can say their hair. As you can see that from reference picture, I am just doing a outlining thing and just shadowing the darker portions, or I can say that just going darker for charcoal pencils. If you are not even used to it with a charcoal pencils, you can make this sketch perfect. I said perfect. For every sketches we use for emotions, for any other things, we use shadows, highlighted things for making a perfect sketch. For her eyebrows, or I can say that for any sketch, we use shadowing, highlighting or many other things. But as you can see from this picture or a reference picture, I've just used a line below his eyes for making emotions, or I can say that he's smiling. I've just used line. I have not shadowed that, but it's still looking good. and the main reason is that I am just used a main particular thing for his face, not every part but a particular thing. Go for detailed, or I can say that small hairs are coming out from his head too. So go for detailed part with shadowed, or I can say the sharpened charcoal pencils. Don't go for darkened pencils, or I can say that pencils that are not sharpened, because if you will go for a lighter portion is hairs, then it will look totally different from a reference picture. And the main focus of this sketch will be going darker to darker, not using any graphite pencils. As you can compare it from a reference picture, I have just done eyes and his hairs, and this sketch is looking perfect before even completing it. And the main, or I can say that the reason behind, is that detailing it with charcoal pencils. You can use this procedure in every other sketch you can do, but this sketch will not look realistic, as every motions, or I can say that every other detail thing, is not gonna happen just by detailing with a charcoal pencils. You have to use shadow or highlighted things if you want to do a realistic pencil. But if you are going for a perfect sketch just in a time limit, or you can say that you have just 1 hour to complete a sketch, you can go for this sketch, or I can say that this technique. This technique will help in improving your outlining part, or I can say that parts which are just useful for a perfect portrait sketch. The non-useful portrait sketch, or I can say that non-useful shadowed parts on any portrait sketches, I have just neglected them. So this technique is useful for a particular portions, not every portraits, or if you are doing a commissioned artwork, I recommend don't go for this sketch. This sketch, or I can say that this technique, is just useful for a particular portions for a quick sketch, not a realistic sketch, but this will look a perfect sketch. Main important portions for his middle face is his cheeks that are just doing a little bit of line portions, and his moustache. I can say that in every sketch I used layer portions, or I can do direct portions for nose or any other things, but just focus on this picture, or I can say the reference picture, there is nothing that can be highlighted or any other things, but it is still looking like a nose. And the main reason is that the highlighted portions will always be below the nose. So just darkening the moustache and below his nose, the nose will be coming out, or I can say that pop out from this portrait picture. You don't have to highlight or don't have to shadow any other portions. As you can see that there is a little bit of lighter portions on right hand side of his moustache. So you can go for direct, or I can say that darkening them or lightening them. I will darken them because the little bit of detailing thing on his right hand side of his moustache will not look good if I will go for detailed, or I can say that spacing between them. Now for his chin area, or I can say the darkened area for his moustache, which is the most important thing for this particular reference picture, I'm just going darkening a portions that are useful. Not going for every other part or detailing or shadowing them, just going for little bit of chin area, darkening them. Or as you can see that there is a little bit of portions that is missing from his moustache behind, or I can say that between the moustache and a chin area. You can leave that area for before shading, or I can say that leave that area for any shading portions, or I can say darkening portions, but I will go for shading them, or I can say that darkening with a charcoal pencil. If you are looking for a good quality charcoal pencils, I've given some links in my descriptions, you can buy from them. Those are really good and I'm still using them. Or I can say that if you are looking for A4 size good quality drawing papers that I'm just using in this sketch, you can go for that link too in my description. Now for his beard, it is looking too sharpened, or I can say that it is looking too shady or a thin in his chin area and his moustache area too. So I'm just using charcoal pencils for layer a bit of strokes. You can go for harder strokes also. I have used harder grip in every part of this sketch. I have not used any other softened, or I can say that middle portions of his sketch just gone for darker portions. I have not even blended any other portions of this charcoal. As you can focus from a reference picture, for completing this sketch, there is a little bit of portion that is hairs. I have just darkened them. And for his chin and his portrait, or I can say that his cloth area, there is a little bit of darker portions between neck. I have just highlighted them with charcoal pencils. So if you have loved this video or you have learned this technique, just hit that subscribe button. Or if you have liked this video, just hit that like button. Share it with your friends. Thank you so much. I will get back with a new video soon. Thank you.